I'm most proud of my heritage in the sense of the fact that African Americans are people of strength. We are a people of perseverance, and we are a spiritual people. And when you put those things together, I think you get a community of folks who are loving, kind, we embrace all people, and at the same time, we have a way of loving one another that maybe is not experienced anywhere else. Only in a NASA environment is when you're allowed to actually exercise those things that you bring to the table that are unique to you, those things that are critical to the mission, and watch them come together and mold together such that you address the NASA mission, you see this product flying off into space. And when I was in school at MIT, there's nothing better than actually doing the space stuff. Putting stuff into orbit just doesn't compare to driving a car or building a car. Well, I'm the product of two teachers from a small town in South Louisiana. And it is a highlight. It is an unexpected emergent property that a small boy from South Louisiana who had no idea what he was going to do when he got to college ended up at NASA. Having dealt with and played with Major Matt Mason as a kid, you know, with space toys, never thought in my wildest dreams that I would be here at NASA doing the things that I do today. And it's only through the grace of God that I'm here. In preparation for working with NASA, especially those that are young, I would suggest that they learn to, one, read well, write well, understand math, and continue to study science along with that along the way. The other part of it is that get comfortable speaking about what's important to you. I learned a long time ago that you can have a great idea, but if you're not able to communicate that idea in written or oral forms, the idea doesn't exist. And until it leaves your brain and is communicated to someone else, it just won't exist. And that how great you are and how wonderful you are, the world will never know. The reason that I am an engineer is because it came from my grandfather, and then my dad after that. My grandfather could build anything. He could visualize it and then create it out of nothing. But he was never able to do it in an environment where he had the support of communities. You know, he did it from a survival standpoint. But those skills and capabilities, I watched him and my father and my uncles do those things. And that just inspired me to figure out how stuff works. Why do things work the way that they do? And then turn that around and then get it formalized into an engineer or the engineering discipline. So